We've been doing lecture-based learning for 80 years here at BFA. And even though we have an incredibly skilled professional staff, we need to be looking at ways to customize student learning, create flexible opportunities for student learning, and repurpose our resources in a way that benefits all students. Because I believe we can do a better job.
What we need are two things. A new model, I think, which we are in the process of building. And I also think we need a more vigorous relationship with business, industry, and higher ed. And I think we need to design multiple pathways with kids, not something we design for them, but with them, to help them navigate their way through what we call school.
We need to be able to think about ways that students can do it differently, in a way that capitalizes on their interest and motivation, and makes it relevant to a larger picture. When students sit down, they have no problem telling us how they learn best, what they think they would like to learn, what their goals and aspirations are. We need to find more efficiency to catapult them into a really meaningful learning experience.
Bellows Free Academy is the largest high school in Franklin County, Vermont. Founded in 1930, BFA serves roughly 1,150 students from a variety of sending towns, in addition to the city and town of St. Albans themselves. Students who attend Bellows Free Academy come from a blend of rural, urban, and suburban households. Like all high schools, BFA faces a variety of challenges, but the biggest challenge is how to move a school into a 21st century learning model.
I think that schools were built to serve a different purpose than they need to serve today. They were born of an industrial era. They trained workers to be successful in an industrial economy. If you were willing to work hard, there was a good paying job at the end of the day. That no longer exists. That's not the economy of today. Now we need learning communities. We need those students to be able to engage with people in business and industry and the community and higher ed and be able to access all that diversity of experience if they're really going to be ready to move out into a knowledge-based economy. We can't do that within the walls of a high school.
So what we can do with the design team expertise we have here at BFA is create Academy 21. Academy 21 is a competency-based high school that utilizes a blended learning model designed to deliver real-time, anytime, responsive, direct, and supplemental instruction. In Academy 21, authentic, relevant, engaging, project-based learning is facilitated by one-to-one computing and a comprehensive learning management platform.
One-to-one computing has boosted the interest level of students in their learning. As a result of an increase in interest, motivation and engagement in learning is also increased, and therefore the outcomes, the output of students, what they're producing is much better. It enhances learning, as I said earlier, first and foremost, because students become engaged with the technology. They're digital natives. It's part of their passion, it's part of their daily lives. So that in and of itself is a great hook for kids. It's clean, it's paperless, communication is instant, feedback is instant, and that's proved invaluable to even just providing feedback for students to improve what they're doing, they're performing and turning into me. It's a logical next step. It really is.
Not all the students are going to catch on or understand at the same point, at the same time, at the same level. So when we score with standards, it's a better reflection of where the student is and where they are in learning, applying concepts, understanding and problem solving. In the real world working situation, you're given a task, you do the task. If it doesn't meet the expectations of your boss, you don't get a grade and move on to the next one. You have to go back to the drawing board, you have to rework it, you have to make improvements on it, and you have to meet the expectations of what the job is. So why shouldn't education be the same way?
How do we make those kinds of changes and still, as you might say, keep school at the same time? Common Core gives us tremendous opportunity to leverage competency-based learning. Thinking about how that learning can occur flexibly is absolutely necessary because the Common Core looks very different than the way we deliver standards and curriculum right now. If we think of learning more in terms of modules of learning that are needed to move to the next level, students can demonstrate that in many different ways, and time is very flexible in that model.
when we've recognized that a student has untapped potential, we have to become more flexible with that student, flexible with the schedule, flexible with the resources we're able to bring to help that student really expand their learning. We've been able to do that with a few students at BFA. We have one student that was interested in becoming an art educator. We don't have any education classes here at BFA. We've been able to pair that student with a local art teacher, flex some time into that student's schedule, and that student now is going to be able to spend second semester working with that art teacher, exploring if she really wants to become an art teacher. What we want to be able to do is to be able to provide flexibility for all students.
I kind of found a new passion for art that I didn't have before, and so I created a class. I approached Mr. Coolidge and my art teachers, and well, I'm going to go to Sheldon and teach with an art teacher there part-time. We're building a curriculum and we're starting to try new things, and I'm excited to learn about teaching from an actual teacher and be in the classroom and not just hear about it from a textbook. And this is going to allow me to experience a lot of different things that aren't necessarily open to the general student population.
We often talk about, you know, we're preparing students for their future. Students will tell you very clearly they're ready right now to do meaningful and relevant work. The kind of flexible learning that we've envisioned, cohorts of students working on projects, working on problem-centered learning in really meaningful, relevant ways where they feel empowered as learners and where they can see the results of their learning immediately and they understand what evidence of learning really looks like.
I think it's a tremendously exciting time to be involved in public education, but I think we need to define public education in a much more broad way because our success is dependent upon all of our other partners. And as they step up, really, the future looks very bright, I think, for our region and for BFA. BFA has a nimbleness and an agility and some enthusiasm right now. We're in the right place at the right time with the right partners. Now just get out of our way, right?
The bottom line is this is about students and student learning. We have a committed professional staff. We have a team of experts ready to move things forward. We have the support of our parents, the community, our students. We need your support as well to make this happen, not only to benefit the students that are here now, but for future generations of students to come.